بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. إن شاء الله tonight we continue our discussion concerning the articles of al-Iman. Last time we were here, we were talking about believing in the messengers of Allah, al-Iman of the Rusul. Including in that, we talked about believing in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he is the last messenger. We have to believe that what he said was the truth and to follow his teaching, to love him and to make him the ruler and the judge over our affairs. We have to be victorious to him. It's upon us to believe that he was sent for humanity, for everybody. You need to turn it up a little bit. He was sent for humanity and he was sent as mercy for everything. Also, we start by saying tonight that related to believing in him is not for the people to raise their voice higher than his voice. For the people not to raise their voice higher than the voice of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And there is people who raise their voice higher than his voice. At this time, at his time when he was alive, that was done by physically raising their voice over his personal voice. And they did that, some people, they did that in trying to argue with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Or some people, they were calling upon the Prophet in a way that represents some disrespect. Or some people might come to his houses and they call upon him from behind the door. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the beginning of Surah Al-Hujurat, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيِّ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. He said, oh, who believe, do not put forth any argument before Allah and His Messenger. That is taqwa with Allah. Verily Allah hears and He knows. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ وَلَا تَجْهَرُوا لَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ كَجَهْرِ بَعْضِكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ أَنْ تَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. All who you believe, do not raise your voices higher than the voice of the messenger, the prophet, and do not speak aloud to him just like you speak to each other. Verily that might render your deed void and you are heedless in this situation. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَغُضُّونَ أَصْوَاتَهُمْ عِنْدَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ امْتَحَنَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ لِلتَّقْوَى لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ. Those who lower their voices at the presence of the Messenger of Allah are those whose heart was tested positive for taqwa, meaning they have taqwa in their heart. Those will receive forgiveness and great reward. And then it says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُنَادُونَكَ مِنْ وَرَاءِ الْحُجُرَاتِ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. Those who call upon you from behind the doors while you are inside the rooms and they are outside, and they call upon you, oh Muhammad, come out. Most of those people, they have no sense. And if they were patient until you come out to them, that will be better for them. Verily, Allah is forgiver and Allah is merciful. So in those ayat, we have to learn that we cannot raise our voices higher than the voice of the Prophet. The voice of the Prophet now is represented by his sunnah, the ahadith that he said.
the action that he approved. All of that represents his voice. Therefore, it's not befitting for those who believe in him to raise their voices in objection, to bear their voices in argument, because human people, humankind, are argumentative in their nature. They love to argue about everything. So people who believe in Allah's Messenger, they should not raise their voices over the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in objection, in argument, in arguing, or in debating the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But part of due to their belief in him is to say to his teaching, we listen and we obey. And listening and obedience should be implemented in all the rules. Those which we understand the wisdom behind them and those which we do not understand the wisdom behind them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us about certain people. If they were called to Allah and His Messenger to rule, they will turn away in objection. But if the rule was in their favor, they will submit to it. What's wrong with those people? Do they have sickness in the heart? Or do they have doubt in the Sunnah of the Prophet? Or are they afraid that Allah and His Messenger will transgress towards them and against them? No. Those people are the transgressors. Because the statement of the believers, if they were called to Allah and His Messenger, they say we listen and we obey. So due to our belief in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is to listen and to obey in things that are compatible with our inclinations and desires and things that are not compatible with our inclinations and desires. Things that are compatible with the inclinations and the desires of our life and things that are not compatible with the inclinations and desires of our wife. So we have to listen and obey in totality, inshallah. Also, due to our belief in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we should not extol the Prophet. We should not overly praise the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he was a prophet, a messenger, and the slave of Allah. And he attained the highest level of closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he will be the person who will be in that praise, station praise, al-maqam al-mahmood. Nevertheless, he is not a partner to Allah. Nor he is worthy of worship. Nor does he have any divinity to him. Therefore, those who attach divinity to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or those who think that the Prophet knows things that is exclusive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are extolling the Prophet. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تطروني كما أطرت النصارى عيسى بن مريم إنما أنا عبد فقولوا عبد الله ورسوله. They do not extol me, similar to how the Nasara did extol Isa ibn Maryam. Verily, I am only a slave. So say the slave of Allah and His Messenger. So the people who believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they have to believe that he was a human and he is not worthy of worship, nor he can bring good to you or keep evil from befalling you. Therefore, we cannot call upon him, but we call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we believe in him, and we call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only without any association, we will be those people who are worthy of his intercession. Having said that, inshaAllah, we close the subject concerning believing in the messengers, and we believe to the fifth article of al-Iman, which is to believe in the hereafter, to believe in the last day, al-Iman bil-Yawm al-Akhir. الإيمان باليوم الآخر يبدأ من الموت. To believe in the last day starts when a person dies. Because when a person dies, they say قامت قيامته. When a person dies, his year, his end has come. His قيامة has been established. So the first thing in believing in the year after is to believe in the punishment of the grave and the joy of the grave. When people die, they move to a dimension that is not something intangible for us. That is the dimension of al-barzakh, al-hayat al-barzakhiyya, the life of the grave. This life and this state is not tangible for us, and this dimension is not tangible for us. But nevertheless, it exists. When people die, whether they are buried or eaten or burnt or whatever it is, people start into al-hayat al-barzakhiyya. When people start in the hayat al-barzakhiyya, some of them might receive punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and some of them might receive goodness and reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran has indicated clearly that the punishment of the grave is something that is real. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذِ الظَّالِمُونَ فِي غَمَرَاتِ الْمَوْتِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ بَاطِفُوا أَيْدِيهِمْ أَخْرِجُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ الْيَوْمِ تُجْزَوْنَ عَذَابَ الْهُونِ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَقُولُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ غَيْرَ الْحَقِّ وَكُنْتُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِهِ تَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. فالشاهد كلمة اليوم، فإذا ماتوا بدأ عليهم العذاب، وهذا عذاب القبر. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى: If you see the transgressor as they are in the agony of death, and the angels are extending their hands and telling them, let your soul come out. Today, you're going to taste the humiliating torment because you used to say the untruth about Allah and you used to be arrogant towards His Son. So it says today, and that is the evidence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that punishment is initiated immediately after their death. And immediately after their death, they will be in the graveyard, in the grave living, in hayat al-barzakh, in that dimension. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَحَاقَ بِآلِ فِرْعَوْنَ سُوءُ الْعَذَابِ النَّارُ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا غُدُوًا وَعَشِيًّا وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةِ أَدْخِلُوا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ أَشَدَّ الْعَذَابِ. He said, the people of Fir'aun, they were surrounded with the most severe type of punishment. The nar, they will be exposed to it in the morning and in the evening. And in the day of judgment, enter the Al Fir'aun to the severe torment. So this ayah tells us and shows us how the punishment started to the people of Fir'aun after their death, and they will be exposed to the hellfire in the morning and in the evening. So those are the evidence that the punishment of the grave is something which is real. And so we have from the Sunnah that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said when he was passing by, and he said, those people in the grave, they are receiving punishment. One of them, he used to carry on the speech and do namima, and the other one used not to clean himself after urination. So this is an evidence from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that this punishment in the grave. This punishment of the grave is directed on the soul, and the body is receiving the punishment consequently. This punishment of the grave is done on the soul, and the body is receiving also the punishment. Some people who are in Islam, they say this is something like is not real, something that is not tangible, but this is something that is sensual. It has no reality to it. we say no, the punishment of the grave is real. And the soul will agonize and the body will agonize consequently. Very similar to sleeping. When a person sleeps, if a person sees himself that he was beaten up, that is directed to his soul initially. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selects the souls when people are sleeping. But nevertheless, when a person wakes up, he feels that really as if he was beaten up. Similar to that is the punishment of the grave, directed initially to the soul, and the body is receiving the consequences of that. And when we say the body, it does not mean the body has to be intact. The body must be burned and eaten and all of that, but still every part of that body is receiving the punishment. Subhanallah, الذي لا إله إلا هو. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لو أن لا تدافنوا لدعوت الله أن يسمعكم من عذاب القبر. Isn't that not, you will not go in panic, I will ask Allah, you will not go in panic and die, I will ask Allah for him to let you hear the punishment of the grave. So the punishment of the grave is severe path of punishment. And when we believe in the year after, we have to believe in the punishment of the grave. And the punishment of the grave, as I said, it's directed on the soul, and the body is getting the agony of it also. Whereas in this life, most of the punishment is directed on the body, but the soul gets the consequences of that also. في هذه الدنيا العذاب يكون على الجسد والروح تابعة له، وأما في القبر العذاب يكون على الروح والجسد تابع له. And in paradise, the joy will be full. The joy will be on the body and on the soul at the same level. And the punishment will be on the body and on the soul at the same level. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the people of paradise. Secondly, we have to believe in the angels who come and ask the people in the grave. In the hadith that narrated by At-Tirmidhi, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا قُبِرَ أَحَدُكُمْ أَتَاهُ مَلَكَانِ أَسْوَدَانِ أَزْرَقَانِ يُقَالُ لِأَحَدِهِمَا الْمُنْكِرِ وَلِآخِرِ وَلِلْآخَرِ النَّكِيرِ. When a person is buried, two angels that they are yellowish black, they come to him, not yellowish, bluish black. They come to him, this is their color, bluish black. They come to him and one of them is named Al-Munkir and the other one is named Al-Nakir. Those are the two angels that come and ask the person who is in the grave. They ask him, who is your Lord, who is your religion, what is your religion, and who is your prophet. Also, the person in the grave will either receive punishment or receive torment. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith narrated by Al-Bukhari, إِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ إِذَا مَاتَ عُرْضَ عَلَيْهِ مَقْعَدُهُ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ إِنْ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ فَمِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ وَإِنْ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ فَمِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ يُقَالُ هَذَا مَقْعَدُكَ حَتَّى يُقِيمُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أو كلمة نحوها. If one of you died, his seat will be shown to him in the evening and in the morning. If he was of the people of paradise or if he was in the people of the hellfire, it will be said to him, this is your seat until Allah, until the day of judgment comes. Thirdly, believing in the last day, we have to believe in al-ba'th, the resurrection. everybody will be resurrected. And this resurrection is something that is, we can understand it by our mind and by our instinct. Our minds tell us there must be a resurrection. Or is it only, as they say, أَرْحَامٌ تَدْفَعْ وَأَرْضٌ تَبْلَعْ. It's not like that. There must be a resurrection. Then if we think about it rationally, it's just like we live like that and we do whatever we do. Some people are transgressed against, and some people, they are the transgressor. And people take the rights of others, and people die, and there will be the end of it. It's not something that agrees with the rational human being. So thinking about this life rationally indicates for us there must be a day that the people will get together and establish their affairs according to the justice. Also, of course, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to us about resurrection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَسُعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. It says, a blown was done in the sur, in the horn. So everybody in the heavens and the earth, except those who Allah excluded, they were in the shock and they died. And then another blow was directed in the horn, and all of them, they are up looking. This ayah of Surah Az-Zumar indicates for us and tells us that the people will be resurrected. Also from the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he says that every part of the son of Adam will decay except ajb al-zanab, except that bone that will be at the lowest part of the back. From that part the son of Adam was created, and from that part the son of Adam will be put back together. So this hadith I was mentioning is in Sahih Muslim, according to Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه. He said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم ما بين النفختين أربعون. يرحمكم الله. قالوا يا أبا هريرة أربعون يوما؟ قال أبيت. قالوا أربعون شهرا؟ قال أبيت. قالوا أربعون سنة؟ قال أبيت. قال ثم ينزل الله من السماء ماء فينبتون كما ينبت البقل. قال وليس من الإنسان شيء إلا يبلى إلا عظما واحدا وهو عجب الذنب ومنه يركب الخلق يوم القيامة. This hadith narrated by Imam Muslim. Abu Huraira said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is 40 between the first blow and the second blow. They said, oh Abu Huraira, is it 40 days? He said, Abaytu. He said, I'm not going to talk about that. He said, they said 40 months, he said, Abaytu. They said 40 years, he said, Abaytu. That means the 40 was not specified, whether 40 days, 40 years, 40, whatever. And he said, then Allah will bring water from the sky. So the people will grow just like vegetation. People will grow just like vegetation. Because the son of Adam, and then it's the Prophet ﷺ said, everything in the son of Adam will be deteriorated except one bone, and that is bone عجب الذنب. عين, on the عين there's فتحة, جيم, and on the جيم there's سكون, باء. And it is the lowest bone on the باء. الذنب, نعم. And from that bone, the human will be reconstructed on the Day of Judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also indicated that in the Quran, He said, فَأَنْزَلْنَا بِهِ مَاءً فَأَخْرَجْنَا بِهِ مِنْ كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ كَذَلِكَ نُخْرِجُ الْمَوْتَى لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thought, in the Quran as he will bring life to the dry, to the dead land. He said water will come over that land and vegetation from all the fruits will come out. Similar to that, the dead will be resurrected for you to reflect upon it. For those people who deny that there will be something there is called resurrection, we tell those people, go to this land which is barren, which does not have any vegetation in it, which does not have any life in it. When we see the rain coming over this land, you see vegetation coming out. The one who can do that with the water and make the dead land alive again is capable and able to bring back the people after they are vacated, to bring them back to existence. So we believe in the Day of Judgment, we believe in Al-Ba'th. And we believe in Al-Hashr. Al-Hashr, where the people will be grouped. All the people will be grouped together, Al-Hashr. Al-Hashr will take place in the land of Al-Sham. أرض المحشر والمنشر الشام. الحشر الله سبحانه وتعالى said, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يحشر الناس يوم القيامة حفاة عراة غرلا. The people in the Day of Judgment, they will be grouped together, barefoot, naked, and uncircumcised. When a person is circumcised, that piece of skin, they will be cut and thrown away. Don't think you lost that piece of skin. When people are resurrected, that piece of skin will join the body and come all together. And the people will be naked and they will be barefoot. Aisha radiallahu anha said, the people will be looking at each other. He said, the affair will be much more serious for people to have any ability or any mind or desire to look at each other. Everybody will be busy with his own self. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَحَشَرْنَاهُمْ فَلَمْ نُغَادِرْ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا. We grouped them, Allah did not leave anyone. This is الْحَشَرْ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. This is the hashr for the Day of Judgment. But there is another hashr, which is الْحَشَرْ إِلَى دَارِ الْمُسْتَقَرِ. The hashr that will be, people will be grouped to their ending, to their final residency. So there is the hashr that will be for the judgment, and then there will be the hashr for the final residency. When the hashr comes for the mawqif, for the Day of Judgment, everybody will be together. But for the hashr, for the dar al-mustaqar, the believers will be different than the disbelievers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ويوم نحشر المتقين إلى الرحمن وفدا. هذا النوع من الحشر إلى دار المستقر. حشر خاص للمتقين. Allah will group those who are pious to those who are pious will be grouped to الرحمن in groups. They are wafd, and the wafd is something that is honorable. The wafd, when you say a wafd came to us, they come and they are wafd. What does wafd in English mean? Yeah, maybe a delegation. Wafda. They come and they are together. Maybe they are riding and in the night style. Whereas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about al-hashr ila dar al-mustaqar, about those who are transgressor, وحشر الذين ظلموا وأزواجهم وما كانوا يعبدون من دون الله فهدوهم إلى صراط الجحيم. A group, those who are transgressors, and those who are similar to them. Azwajahum does not mean their wives, but those who are similar to them. And everything that they used to worship, and lead them to the path of al-jahim, to the path of fire. Ibn al-Qayyim said in his book, Miftah Dar al-Sa'adah, فَعِنْدَ الْحَشْرِ الْأَوَّلِ يَسْمَعُونَ وَيُبْصِرُونَ وَيُجَادِلُونَ وَيَتَكَلَّمُونَ وعند الحشر الثاني يحشرون على وجوههم عميا وبكما وصما. He said, at the first gathering, the people will see and they will hear and they will argue and they will speak. But at the second gathering, when every group will be gathered to his final residency, they will be making the hashr on their faces, blind, mute,
blind and mute and deaf. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, how can they be making the hashr on their faces? How can they walk on their faces? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who was able to make them walk on their feet, he will be able to make them walk on their feet. So there will be al-hashr in the day of judgment. Also, there will be al-ard wal-hisab. People will be exposed and people will be reckoned with. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَوْمَ إِذٍ تُعْرَضُونَ لَا يَخْفَى مِنْكُمْ خَافِيَةً. And that day, you will be shown. And nothing you do will be concealed. Everything will be known. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will know everything. And after that arab, people will be reckoned, or some people may not be reckoned. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَيْسَ أَحَدْ يُحَاسَبْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَ إِلَّا هَلَكَ فَأَمَّا قَالَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا وَيُصْلَى سَعِيرًا إِنَّهُ كَانَ فِي أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا. صحيح؟ ويصلى سعيرا إنه كان في أهله مسرورا. عائشة said, when that ayah was mentioned, Aisha said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how come then you are saying everybody who will be reckoned on the day of judgment, he will be destroyed? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, whoever was reckoned, bil hisab, and his book was given in his right hand, he will be happy and he will go to his family in happiness. He said this is al-arab, because anyone who was given the examination, he was given the test, he was given the questioning in detail, except everyone who will be doing that to him, he will receive the punishment. So from that we know those people who will be reckoned with in detail, those people will be receiving punishment. Those people who will be questioned in detail, those people will be receiving punishment. But those people who will be questioned in the arad fashion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save them. So this is al-arad wal-hisab in the day of judgment. Also we have to believe in al-mizan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment will put al-mizan. And people, their deeds will be put in al-mizan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ. So al-mizan, you say, whoever his scales are heavy, he is in a happy ending. And whoever his scales are light, he is in a hellfire. So there will be al-mizan, and the actions will be put in al-mizan. Our actions that we do, and they have no weight to them. We do not see them. You cannot go and put your prayer on the scale. You can put your meat and chicken, but you cannot put the prayer on the scale. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn all of those actions to tangible objects that will be put on the scale. Also, the person itself must be put on the scale. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was a man who was skinny. One time he was walking and the wind came and blew on him, and the wind made him shake his position. So the people smiled at that scene. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what are you laughing about? His foot is heavier than in the scale than the mountain of Uhud. So that is an indication to us that people themselves, those pious, will be put in the scale. So the deed will be put in the scale, and also we have an indication from the Sunnah that the people will be put in the scale.
Also we believe in al-sirat. Al-sirat will be put and established over hell. And every person will have to go and cross this bridge to go to paradise. I tell you, Ya Aswan, crossing over the bridge, crossing over al-sirat, and the way people cross over al-sirat is very much related to how much they are connecting themselves with the al-sirat al-mustaqim in this life. The more of a person on the al-sirat al-mustaqim in this life, the more he will be easy for him to cross the al-sirat over the hellside. And the less of a person on al-sirat al-mustaqim in this life, the less he will be able to cross over the bridge over the hellfire. So those people who are living in a dream, those people who are living in a heedless situation, and they think they can just do little things here and there and zip over the sirat, over the hellfire, they are mistaken. Because that according to how people are over the sirat al-mustaqim in this life, they will be able to cross over al-sirat al-mustaqim in the day after. Allah, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, as describing the people who will cross over the bridge, فَنَاجٍ مُسَلَّمْ وَنَاجٍ مَهْدُوسْ شَذَاكَ اللَّهُ سَيْهِ. فَنَاجٍ مُسَلَّمْ وَنَاجٍ مَهْدُوشٍ وَمَكْدُوسٌ فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمْ. So the people will be, some of them, they will be safe without any scratches. And some people will get saved, but they have scratches. And some people, they will be dipped in the hellfire. Because that sirat that you have to cross over, from the underneath the sirat, hooks come out. And those hooks, they hook the people and throw them in the hellfire. Those people who are hooked on disobeying Allah in this life, those people who are hooked on sinful lifestyle, those people who are hooked, Abu Zahira, on whimsical lifestyle, when they are trying to get over the paradise, the bridge over the hellfire to paradise, those hooks will come out and hook them and throw them in the hellfire. Just like they threw themselves in desires and temptation in this life, they will be hooked and they will be thrown in the hellfire. So we believe in al-sirat. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who cross al-sirat with ease. And also, we believe in the 70,000 people who will enter paradise without any reckoning. Who are they? Who can tell us their quality? نعم. نعم. لا يرقون. ولا يكتوون. في واحد رابع. ولا يتطيرون.
Catheterization.
Right, they all do that. Yeah, this is one. Like the wood, they do not treat themselves with catheterization. And they do not practice superstition. No, they do not practice superstition. They're not superstition. And they do not ask others to make ruqya for them. They do not ask others to make ruqya for them. And they depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to review the first chapter of Al-Tawheed. Because now we are in the 18th chapter, we have to go back, Ya Akhwan, and review those tapes and make sure you know the information in them. If you do not know who those people who enter paradise, those 70,000 people, if you do not know their qualities at least, chances are you're not of them. You have to know them. So you walk away to be of them. Because there's 70,000 of them, and with each 1,000, there's another 70,000. With the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, we believe in the Day of Judgment with the intercession. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will intercede for those who did not have any shirk. Those who do not have shirk, he will intercede for them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, من أسعد الناس بشفاعتك؟ قال من قال لا إله إلا الله خالصا من قلبه. Who is most people who will be most happy and most worthy of your shafa'ah? He says those who will say La ilaha illallah sincerely from their heart. Even though those people might be committing sins and they might be doing some practices in Islam that are not approved in Islam, nevertheless, they did not practice shirk, those people will be happy and pleased with the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Also, we believe in al-ru'ya, that the people, they will see their Lord on the Day of Judgment. And this seeing the Lord on the Day of Judgment is different than seeing Allah in paradise. People will see their Lord on the Day of Judgment, and this vision was authenticated in mutawatir hadith. Many hadith that came to us in the transmission of tawatir, that the people, the believers, will see their Lord on the Day of Judgment. Also, we believe in al-hawd, the pool of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. When the people on the Day of Judgment, they will be thirsty and in agony, and the sun will come close to the people, and people will be sweating. There will be the hawd of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that whose the water of that hawd is whiter than snow and sweeter than honey. And the banks of that pool are from musk. Musk. The banks of the pool from musk, from musk. Smells like musk. And the pool runs and pillars. That is the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some people will be deprived from drinking from that house. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَرِجُ عَلَيَّ أُمَّةِ الْحَوْضَ وَأَنَا أَذُودُ النَّاسَ عَنْهُ كَمَا يَذُودُ الرَّجُلُ إِبِلَ الرَّجُلِ عَنْ إِبِلِهِ. قالوا يا نبي الله تعرفنا؟ قال نعم. لكم سيما ليست لأحد غيركم تردون علي غرلا محلجلين من أثر الوضوء وليصدن عني طائفة منكم فلا يصلون فأقول يا رب هؤلاء من أصحابي فيجيبني ملك فيقول وهل تدري ما أحدث بعدك رواه مسلم. This hadith says people of my nation will come close to me at the pool, at the house. While I was pushing the people away, just like a man will push the camels of another man, not for those camels to drink with his own. They said, O Prophet of Allah, would you know us at that time? He said, yes, because you have certain character that is unique to them. You come to me and the traces of wudu on your body, on your faces and on your hands. But a group of my people, they will be prevented from drinking from the house. I will say, oh Allah, those are of my people, of my companions. Those are of my companions. And his companion does not refer to the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that they were with him. This is companions mean his people, his nation.
He was the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Those who be of my companion, meaning the nation, that refers to his nation. An angel will answer and he say, you do not know what they innovated after you. You did not know what they have innovated after you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to always say, every innovation, every new practice in a religion is an innovation, and every innovation is misguidance, and every misguidance is in the hellfire. كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. Whoever starts in our affair something that is not of our religion is not accepted, it's rejected. So those people who innovate, they will be deprived from drinking from the hawd of the Prophet. And this punishment is very similar in nature to their practice. Because those people, they refuse to drink from the fountain of the Sunnah. They wanted to drink from the fountain of the bid'ah. هؤلاء الناس رفضوا أن يشربوا من سنة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. They refused to drink from the fountain of the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. They wanted to develop their own program. Therefore, consequently, they were deprived to drink from the pool of the Prophet. Those who will drink from the pool of the Prophet indeed are those who drink from his Sunnah. So if you want to go over the Sirat fast, you have to establish yourself on the Sirat, on the Islam, while you are alive. And if you want to drink from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a sip of water that you're never going to feel thirsty after that, you have to drink from his Sunnah. And drink from the pure sources of the Sunnah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who drink from the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Having said that, we talked about believing in the last day, and also part in believing in the last day is to believe in all the things that were said to us concerning paradise. And we have to believe in all the things that were said to us concerning the hellfire. We have to believe that the disbeliever in the hellfire, his size would be something that we cannot imagine. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the thickness of the disbeliever in the hellfire is equivalent to 3 days journey. It's equivalent to the distance that could be traveled in a 3 days journey. This is the thickness of his skin. And his tooth, his molar tooth, will be the size of the mountain of Uhud. That is amazing sight. And the punishment will be put on those people. And every time their skin is cooked, Allah will give them new skin for them to re-experience the punishment. So we have to believe all of that. And we have to believe, I did not make this part detailed in all of the issues. There are many other issues that we did not address. But it suffices for our purpose in our brief explanation for us to make sure that we want to believe in everything that was mentioned concerning the year after.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
So I was saying that this explanation is very brief to fit the purpose of those lessons, but there's many other things that we did not mention. But the most important part we have mentioned, and that is to believe in the punishment of the grave, to believe in the angel that will come and ask in the grave, to understand the nature of the punishment that would be in the administered in the grave, for the joys that would be offered in the grave, to believe in the resurrection, to believe in the hashr, to believe in al-arz al-hisab, to believe in al-mizan. And the mizan is something that is tangible, not something imaginary as some people say. And to believe in al-sirat, to believe in al-shafa'ah, to believe in al-ru'ya, to believe in al-hawd, and to believe in all the things that were said to us concerning paradise, and all the things that were said to us concerning the hellfire. وهذا وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سلم بسنته إلى يوم الدين. And if you have any questions, inshallah, we'll try to answer them until the Isha prayer.
Because of the names of the angels that are coming in Barzakh, for the question of Munkir and Al-Nakir, but what is the name of the Malik al-Mulk?
There's no name for Malik al-Mulk.
That's right. I'm looking for it. It's for real.
You don't know the name of it. Yes.
You said that Allah will increase the size of the kuffar and the hellfire. Is there some wisdom behind that?
For them to tolerate that fire, not to melt right away.
So they made them big like that.
Big. So the bigger they are, the more punishment would be feeling. The bigger they are, the more punishment would be experiencing or felt. Yes.
Do you know when Jesus will be?
I don't know if any people will be resurrected to the way they were, I believe, have died. But people will enter paradise according to the shape of Adam. The shape of Adam was created at length of 60 feet high. So the people will enter paradise in that shape. And also the hadith says that people of paradise, they will enter paradise. Uhlan, murdan, jurdan, abna, thalatha wa thalathin. The people will enter paradise and their eyes are kuhl, and their skin is soft, and their face is soft. There's no hair on their face. And they would be at the age of 33. وجوه يومئذ ناعمة. Faces at that day will be smooth. نعم. بالعربي. جواب بالعربي. Well, you have to have this light in this light for you not to have it. البدن نفسه يعني بدن يوضع في الميزان يرجح كفة الحسنات
يعني
يوضع
مع الحسنات؟
نعم يوضع مع الحسنات؟ نعم يوضع، لأنه هذه من الموازين، يعني من الشيء الذي يوزن هو الحسنات، ومن الذي يوزن هو الصالح نفسه، كما دل على ذلك حديث عبد الله، الحديث الذي في شأن عبد الله بن مسعود.
يعني
نعم.
Can you give me the name? You mentioned first the 70,000 people. What were the conditions?
You have to go back to the first chapter of Al-Tawfiq, inshallah.
Also the names of the, you said we also believe in this and we believe in that. I need the Arabic term you was using, some of the Arabic terms I need to change.
What are those Arabic terms?
Some of the ones I didn't get.
All of those terms that you did not get, go back up to the tape and find them. You are talking about the Hashar and Nashar.
Right, but you didn't mention the English meaning of some of them. Some of them I caught by the, you explaining it. I'll get it later.
Inshallah. We've said Al-Ba'ath, which means resurrection.
Right, yeah, yeah.
Al-Hashr, which means the grouping of the people, the reckoning and the showing, Al-Ard wal-Hisab, Al-Ard wal-Hisab, Al-Mizan, which is the scale, Al-Sirat, which is the path, the bridge.
And you call
you have to believe in Al-Shafa'a, which is the intercession. الرؤية which is the seeing the Lord and الحوض which is the pool.
Yeah.
Yes.
The first people.
You got them. Was it in the book of Tawheed? We were asking you about that or in this? Yes.
No, you didn't say. We have discussed it.
Yeah, so you have to give me the answer in the book of Tawheed. نعم, تمرنا the book of Tawheed, inshaAllah.
You also said the Hawth,
and the Kawthar, or different names? No, the Kawthar is the river, and the Hawth is filled from the Kawthar.
Two different.
Yeah, Al Hawth is the pool, and this pool is filled from the water of Al Kawthar. Yeah. We haven't said that, inshallah. We'll finish our lesson tonight. وهذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.